Phoenix, lots of people can, and have, laid claim to narrowly turning Arizona for President-elect Joe Biden last month. But there are few who can do so more convincingly than Cindy McCain. Her respectful support for Biden, coming from a lifelong Republican and widow to the late Senator John McCain, who dominated Arizona politics for decades, arguably helped push just enough GOP women into the Democrats' column to win what turned out to be the closest state in the country. Biden defeated President Donald Trump in Arizona by fewer than 11,000 votes. It was only the second win for a Democrat in Arizona since 1948. In an interview with the Arizona Republic, which is part of the USA Today network, McCain said she had been reluctant to get involved but is satisfied with the result and looking ahead to seeing Republicans have a seat at the table in the Biden administration, perhaps including her. "Like everyone else, I couldn't sit still any longer. I had to do something," she said Wednesday. "When I did it, I jumped in with all fours. I did all the commercials. I did over 50 interviews in a one-month period, which is pretty intense. I obviously wanted us to win Arizona, and I think I had some effect on some of the other states, too," McCain said. "I'm very happy with what happened and I'm very proud to have played a small part in all of this to bring him over the finish line." On September 22, 2 weeks before voting got underway in Arizona, McCain publicly endorsed Biden, citing her long-standing friendship and respect for someone who usually disagreed with her husband, but never wavered in his love of country. "I made a plea like so many others. Look, I'm a Republican, I'm going to remain a Republican, but we deserve better," she said. Coming from McCain, the woman whom Republicans wanted to make First Lady in 2008, it received national attention and wound up as part of the argument Democrats made to urge Republicans to cross over because of Trump's polarizing politics. McCain appeared in ads for Unite the Country, a political action committee that advocated for Biden's election and targeted what it considered a million persuadable veterans in battleground states, such as Pennsylvania and Arizona. "The response we got was phenomenal, in terms of people watching them to the finish," said Steven Schale, the executive director of the PAC. "When you would test the efficacy of the spots, they were doing really well with focus groups that a couple of groups were doing. You know, I think the thing about Mrs. McCain is she could validate Joe Biden as a person in a way that very few people could. The message we were able to eventually get up on TV in Pennsylvania and also in the digital world I think just provided the answer to that real important last-minute reassurance to voters who probably were the types of voters who voted for Trump and didn't really want to do it again."